हेलो, मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी।
मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
शैल वी स्टार्ट?
यस।
नाउ यस्टरडे वी हैव सीन द कंटिन्यूटी इक्वेशन। वी हैव डायरेक्ट द कंटिन्यूटी इक्वेशन व्हिच इज डो यू एक्स बाय डो एक्स प्लस डो यू वाई बाय डो वाई प्लस डो यू जेड बाय डो जेड इज इक्वल टू जीरो। ओके, आई एम जस्ट showing the screenshots which was there in the live board, yesterday's live board. Let's see once again. Yesterday, this was the equation. Can you able to see the live board screenshots?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. This was the final equation which we have already derived yesterday. Okay. Now we will use this equation and along with this yesterday's 14 equation number 14 for the component A we already derived midway of the derivation we arrived at this equation equation 14. We will use these two equations in our next derivation, which is fixed second law of diffusion. Okay, and then I will share my live board here. Okay, can you able to see the live board?
Sir, yes, sir, we can.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, thank you. Okay, then now the derivation is fixed second law. Fixed second law is our derivation. Then what about fixed first law? Okay, we already seen previously fixed second law is this states the relationship between diffusivity relationship between flux and concentration gradient. Okay, then we will look first what is fixed first law of diffusion. Fixed first law of diffusion, what does it states? Flux with respect to a arbitrary coordinate, any arbitrary coordinate is directly proportional to the negative of concentration gradient, dou Ca by dou x or dou y or dou z. So what he is saying, the proportionality constant is equal to dAb, which is known as diffusivity of A through B. Minus is already there in the previous equation. So dou Ca by dou x or dou y or dou z. This is called fixed first law. These two equations are concerned with first law, fixed first law. Okay, then next one, now we have to see clearly what is fixed second law. Okay, we already derived the relationship between diffusivities in the previous classes, which is relationship between diffusivity fluxes. Relationship between fluxes, which is JA and NA, or for the I species JI or NI, JI and NI. Okay, from the previous equations or the previous derivation, we can write relationship between diffusivities are NI is equal to N into XA plus N into not when we are writing I. We have to write this also I. When we are writing for A, we have to write A. So Ni plus Ji. Okay. Everybody remember how this equation we obtained. Otherwise, we could derive one more time. Can anybody confirm? Do you remember this equation?
Yes, sir. We remember.
Yeah. Okay. I'm just skipping the derivation once again. Already we derived in the previous classes. So now, this relationship between diffusivities we have to write for component A. For component A, we have to write that equation. When we write for component A, in place of Ni, we have to write Na. Na is equal to N total flux into XA, mole fraction of A, plus flux of A. So we will now give this equation as equation number 2. The previous equation, this is the universal equation, generalized equation, we will give this equation 1. Okay, this is equation number 2. Now flux will have, what are the flux units? Mole per meter square second. So flux, this is the molar flux. Then we want, even our mass transfer, we want the mass flux. Mass flux is kg per meter square second. In order to convert this Na mole to Na mass, we need to just multiply with molecular weight, or gram per gram mole or kg per kg mole. Then mole will be get cancelled. Then we will get a mass flux units, gram per meter square second. So wherever the flux is there, we need to multiply it with molecular weights. So next step will be that one. So multiply equation 2 with molecular weight of A, which is capital MA, okay, which is denoted by capital MA. Then what will happen to that equation? MA into Na is equal to MA into NXA plus MA into JA. So we will give this as equation number 3. So now from the solution laws, what is mole fraction? Mole fraction is nothing but individual concentration divided by total concentration. Okay, concentration, when we are writing the mole fraction for A, we have to write a individual mole concentration is concentration of A, CA, and total concentration C. So XA is nothing but CA by C. So the same formula we will apply here. Substitute XA in equation 3. We need to substitute this XA in equation 3. Then equation 3 is MA into NA is equal to MA into NXA was there. So in place of XA, we are substituting CA by C, okay, plus MA JA. So this is equation 4. Okay, just we are replacing XA with the their definitions, individual concentration divided by total concentration, which is given as equation number 4. Then according to our diffusivities or fluxes, we are defined our flux as Ni is equal to flux with respect to a stationary coordinates is equal to Ci into Ui. From the initial definitions where we are referring to the streams, we have given an example of one sailor is floating around the stream. So we have given that example. During that that derivation, we just define flux as concentration multiplied by velocity. So Ni is equal to Ci into Ui. So since here the flux is also a vector, and this velocity is also a vector, we need to define a common n is equal to C into ux or uy or uz. It can take, since it's a vector, we need to indicate with x, y, z spatial coordinates. Okay, I think this flux definition already you can remember from the previous classes, otherwise you have to go in the class. Then this definition we need to substitute in our equation 4. Substitute Ni is equal to Ci into Ui, or Na is equal to Ca into, if we consider only x component or x direction, Ux in equation 4, previous equation, equation 4. So what is equation 4? Ma into Na is equal to Ma already there. Okay, then in place of capital N, okay, capital N is a total flux, which is Na plus Nb. In place of N, we will substitute total, which is total flux, so total concentration multiplied by x component of velocity ux into xa is there. So in place of xa we are writing ca by c plus left out term is ma plus capital ma plus capital ja. So this is the equation. Now we can cancel out capital C and capital C. Okay, then left out terms will be, left out term is ma into na is equal to ma into ca into ux plus ma ja. So this is the left out term. Now what are the units of this quantity ma into ca? Okay, just we will check the units. Ma will have a units of gram per gram mole or kg per kg mole multiplied by concentration. Concentration will have units of mole per meter cube. So here gram mole cancel. The left out term units will be gram per meter cube, which is nothing but density units. Okay, since we are writing for A here, so we need to write density rho A. So in place of ma into ca, we will substitute this rho A. Rho A is nothing but ma into ca. Okay, this this we will substitute in place of this one. So in this next slide, I am just substituting that one. So ma into na is already there. So in place of ma into ca, I am just substituting rho a into ux plus ma into ja, which we can give equation number 5. Okay, this is the equation. So this equation, now we have to differentiate with respect to the, their spatial coordinates. Okay, just see. I'm just writing, replacing this with erasing this x component so that we can obtain for any number of component here. Just remember this equation number 5. Okay, I'm writing in the next here only. So differentiate, what we have to do next operation, differentiate equation 5 with respect to x component. For the x component we are differentiating, so we have to differentiate for x. So now what we'll get when we differentiate that x, so from equation 5 when we differentiate it, dou ma into na by dou x. So this is the right hand left hand side term. So in the right hand side we have a rho a into ux or rho a into u. Simply, since we are differentiating with x, we have to write ux. Okay, so both these are the variables. Density is also a variable and velocity is also a variable, whereas density is a scalar, velocity is a vector. So using the variable separable law, we can write when we are differentiating the one variable, we have to keep other variable constant. Rho a into dou ux by dou x plus, when we are differentiating other variable, we have to keep the second variable outside the derivative. So here ux into dou rho a by dou x, and the left out terms will be ma is constant, molecular weight of a is constant, dou rho a by dou x. Here also ma is constant, we can take it outside, but for the simplicity I'm just writing inside of derivative only. Molecular weight of any component is a constant. Okay, then this is the equation. We can give this equation number 6, I guess. Yes, 6. Equation number 6, this is. This is equation number 6. Then next, we just simplify that equation. What we have to simplify, we already know what is Ja from the Fick's first law of diffusion. Ja is equal to minus dAb dou Ca by dou x. When we are talking about x component or x direction, this is the equation. We already know this from Fick's first law. So this law needs to be substituted in equation 6, previous equation. Substitute Ja in equation 6, previous equation. So what we will get when we substitute this in previous equation? In a previous equation, we already have dou ma na by dou x is equal to rho a dou ux by dou x plus ux dou rho a by dou x plus ma is there. So in the derivative we have ja. In place of ja, we will just substitute our definition of ja, which is minus dab dou ca by dou x. So this we have already substituted. So just simplify this equation. Now simplifying this equation, what we will get? Dou ma na by dou x is equal to rho a dou ux by dou x plus ux dou rho a by dou x. So plus into minus is just minus, we can write. So ma is already there, dab is there. So dou into dou is dou square ca by dou x into dou x, which is nothing but dou x square. So okay, this is equation number 6. So now similarly, this equation number 6, when we differentiated our equation number 5, when we differentiated our equation number 5 with respect to dx, we got equation number 7. Okay, when we differentiate, similarly same equation we need to differentiate with respect to y for the next spatial coordinates. So next operation is differentiate equation 5 with respect to y spatial coordinates. So same procedure we need to apply here also. Otherwise you just remember this equation. Wherever x is there, we need to just substitute here, replace this x with y. Okay, this is the case. Okay, otherwise you have to go through all the steps which we have followed here. Just for the simplicity, I am showing here for the simplification. So what is the equation number 5? Equation number 5 is nothing but ma into na. So we are differentiating it with respect to y. Dou ma na by dou y is equal to, so from the variable separable, the rho a into dou uy by dou y plus uy dou rho a by dou y plus ma into dou ja by dou y. This is the equation. Okay, now this equation needs to be simplified. So we have to just replace this ja with the definition of fixed first law of diffusion. When we apply that fixed first law of diffusion here, what will happen? We'll just see. So the term in the left hand side is dou ma in ma into na into divided by dou y into rho a dou uy by dou y plus uy dou rho a by dou y plus ma dou by dou x is already there. In place of ja, we are substituting minus dab dou ca by dou y. Since this is the y component, we are writing for y component. Same operations we have to perform once again. So the term will be dou ma na by dou y is equal to rho a dou uy by dou y plus uy dou rho a by dou y. So plus into minus is minus. So ma is already there and dab is already there. Dou into dou ca is called dou ca square by dou y into dou y is nothing but dou y square. So this is equation number 7, yes, 8. Okay, this is equation number 8. Okay, so similarly for the z component also, we need to differentiate equation number 5. for the z component with respect to x. Now, same operations, differentiate equation phi with respect to z component. Okay, already for the two components we already derived. Just simply I'm showing when we obtain one equation for the with respect to x, how to write for other two spatial coordinates. I will just show. Now here you can see here. Just see, for example, in the equation 8, how to derive the equation 9 by visually, we can see here. Just what are the common variables we have? I'm showing in other colors. See here, y is there here, and here also u y is there, and dou y is there, and here dou y square is there. So next one here, y is there, and in the u y is there. Just replace wherever this y is there, we have to replace with z component to obtain equation number 8. So how do we do that one? So in order to do that, the first step is write down that equation, dou ma na z component divided by dou z. Okay, let's see in the previous slide. This is one. So here y will be there. So in place of every y, we will just replace here z. So the next slide. So this one. So already rho a is already there. Rho a dou in place of y, we have to write z. U z by dou in place of y, we have to z, write z. Dou z plus in place of y, we have to write uz, you need to write, and dou rho a by in place of z, we need to write with respect to z. So left out terms are minus ma, so dab, so dou square ca is same, divided by when it is y square, we have to write z square here. Dou ca by dou z. This is called equation number 9. All this is equation 9. Okay, we already obtained equation 8 and equation 9 here. So now from the previous equations, from the previous derivation, which is a continuity equation, we have already obtained in the last class equation number 14. As you can see this screenshot from the yesterday's session, I have taken a screenshot. From this screenshot, equation number 14 is from, and just show my whiteboard. See, from equation 14 of continuity derivation. Okay, what is that continuity derivation? Equation 14. I am just showing on my screen. This is the screenshot of yesterday's session for component A. So I am just writing down in my whiteboard what is that equation. So that equation is nothing but ma of dou by dou x of na x plus dou by dou y of na y plus dou by dou z of na z plus dou rho a by dou t is equal to minus r a m a. So this is equation number 14 of continuity equation derivation. During continuity equation, we derived and we obtained this equation number in the continuity equation itself. Now what we have to do in this equation, we just multiply this ma, okay, this ma inside, okay, so it is common for everything. So we just multiply this equation, just pass on this equation to every quantity which is there inside the brackets. So we will do that in next step. So this one is, so that equation number 14 will become dou by dou x of ma into nx plus dou by dou y of ma into nay plus dou by dou z of na z plus dou rho a by dou t is equal to minus ra into m. When we multiply that ma to all other terms inside, so here ma will be there, all other terms, we will get this equation. Okay, now what we have to do with this equation? So with this equation, we just we can substitute in place of ma na from the previous equations. You can see this equation, equation 7. Yes, equation 7, see ma na x, this is. So equation 7, in place of this one, dou ma na x by dou x, we can substitute the term which is there in the right hand side in this equation. Similarly, from equation 8, in place of this quantity in equation number 14, we can substitute this RHS term. So in place of here, from equation 9, in place of this dou ma na z by dou z, we can substitute this RHS term in equation number 9. So this we have to do in equation number 14. As you can see here, dou by dou x. So from equation, this needs to be substituted from equation 7. The right hand side of equation number needs to be substituted in place of this. And equation number 8, right hand side of equation number 8 needs to be substituted here. In place of this, the right hand side variables of equation number 9 we have to substitute here. So I think this is clear. We have to go through the slides once again, then you can clearly understand. So now from equation number 14, substitute equation 8, 9 and 10. Okay, not 8, 9, 10, 7, 8, 9, yes. Substitute equation 7, 8 and 9 in equation 14 of continuity. Equation 14 doesn't belong to this derivation, whereas equation number 14 is there in the continuity derivation. So we need to remember this. From that continuity equation, we are obtaining that equation number 14. So what will happen? In place of dou ma na x by dou x, we can just substitute, we can write our equation number 7 as dou rho a into dou ux by dou x plus ux into dou rho a by dou x minus ma dab dou square ca by dou x square. This is for the x component, okay? In place of this one. Here in this first slide, you can see here, this is in place of this, we can write that one. Okay, in place of, I'm showing my screen. Okay, in place of this one, we have written that much big equation from equation number 7. Okay, in place of this one, now we have to write with a plus symbol. So, with a plus symbol, I'm writing plus rho a into same equation we have to write for y component, dou y uy by dou y plus uy dou rho a by dou y minus ma dab dou square ca by dou y square. Okay, similarly for the next component, z component, we have to write rho a into dou u z in place of y, we are writing z dou z plus u z dou c a by dou z minus d a b, m a into d a b, dou square c a by dou z square. Okay, for the three components we already written for in place of equation number 14. See, for first component we have written from equation number 7, the second component we have written from equation number 8, and third component we have written from equation number 9. And left out terms are this one, dou rho a by dou t is equal to minus r a into m a. So we have to write there that left out terms. So due to the lack of space, I am writing in the next slide. So continuation from the previous slide. So plus dou rho a by dou t is equal to minus r a into m a. Okay, this is the equation. I think we can give equation number 9. Okay, 9 is already there. Equation number 9, yes, 10 we can give. This is including the previous slide equation, that big equation which I am giving this as equation number 10. Okay, this is equation number 10. Now we have, what we have to do with this equation here, see, in the all these equations we have a rho a as a common term. So here you can see rho a is the common here, and here also rho a is common, and here also rho a is common. So we need to just take it out. So common terms we'll take it out. So I'm writing in the next slide. So common terms, when we take it out, common terms when we take it out, it will become rho a into dou ux by dou x. So from previous slide I'm once again showing, when we replace rho a we will have only dou ux by dou x, and this one, next one dou uy by dou y, then next one dou uz by dou z. We need to write that three terms in terms of bracket, dou uy by dou y plus dou uz by dou z. Okay, then the left out terms, what are the left out terms? Then velocity terms will be there. Then next, the common variables are this velocity. Okay, then these three quantities we need to separately write in terms of this equation. So we will write plus ux dou rho a by dou x plus uy dou rho a by dou y plus uz dou rho a by dou z. Okay, this is the left out terms, and furthermore left out terms will be molecular weight multiplied by diffusivities. You can see from the previous equation, the further left out terms here are these three quantities we need to write in a single single variable. So we need to write this one. So the ma into dab, so we can take common since all the terms are containing only ma into dab. See here, ma into dab is the common. So here see, ma into dab and ma into dab, these three terms are common. So we need to take outside the common terms. So we can write dou square ma into dab, when we take common, dou square ca by dou x square plus dou square ca by dou y square plus dou square ca by dou z square. Okay, this is the equation, and further I am writing in the next slide the left out terms, just indicating plus dou rho a is already there, dou rho a by dou t is equal to minus r a into m u is there. So now we have to apply the assumption. Almost we are at the end of the equation derivation, so we have to apply the assumption. If we assume we don't have a reaction, then this term will become zero because of there is no chemical reaction in it. So the right hand term will become zero. Then from the continuity equation, we see from the continuity equation. What is the continuity equation from the yesterday's last derivation? I am showing the screenshot of that one. So this one we already obtained yesterday. Dou ux by dou x plus dou uy by dou y plus dou uz by dou z is equal to zero. So from continuity equation, from the previous continuity equation, we can write this whole term as zero. Okay, this is zero because from continuity equation we can state this as, from continuity equation we are putting this all the variable as zero. Okay, the first assumption is there is no chemical reaction, so we are keeping, taking this in other color, we are taking this as zero because no chemical reaction. Assumptions I am writing here, no chemical reaction, so RHS term will be zero. And the next assumption is from continuity equation, the first term in the previous equation, this whole term we have taken it as zero. Okay, then the next assumption is, okay, uniform composition. What does that mean? Uniform composition means I already said you, it's independent of spatial coordinates. Okay, uniform means independent of spatial coordinates, whereas steady state means independent of time. So here we are considering uniform. So our this ones are zero due to uniformity, this is zero due to uniformity, this is also zero due to uniformity. So the left out term is only this term. I'm showing the violet color. This is the left out term and these are the left out terms, which I have shown in the violet color. So we will write in the next slide what are the left out terms. So left out terms after all the assumptions is from the LHS side is minus MA DAB dou square CA by dou x square plus dou square CA by dou y square plus dou square CA by dou z square plus dou rho A by dou t is equal to zero. Okay, this is the left out term from that big big variables. So this left out terms will just simplify. We will send this dou rho A by dou t to the right hand side. Just I am writing in the next slide. So left out terms will be C minus MA into DAB dou square CA in a bracket dou square CA by dou x square plus dou square CA by dou y square plus dou square CA by dou z square. When we sent that previous this dou rho a by dou t to the RHS side, it will become negative sign is equal to minus dou rho a by dou t. So minus minus we can cancel out. So the left out terms will be this one. So MA DAB dou square CA by dou x square plus dou square CA by dou y square plus dou square CA by dou z square is equal to dou rho A by dou. So next step is divide whole term, divide both side, divide both sides with MA, with molecular weight of component K. Then what will happen? We'll see in the next slide. Then this will happen. So MA into DAB is already there. So whole term will be divided by MA and the left out terms are dou square CA by dou x square plus dou square CA by dou y square plus dou square CA by dou z square. These are the term in the LHS side and RHS side. The left out terms are though rho a is the left term. So when we divide this whole term with rho a, I am keeping inside this dou rho a by dou t, this one. So this equation, what will happen? This ma when me, we can strike it out. So density divided by molecular weight. The units of density are kg per meter cube divided by molecular weight is kg or kg per kg mole. So kg kg will be cancelled. So mole per meter cube. Mole per meter cube are the units for concentration. Okay. So we can write Ca is equal to rho a by mu. So we need to substitute in the previous equation. Then the final equation will become dAb dou square Ca by dou x square plus dou square Ca by dou y square plus dou square Ca by dou z square is equal to dou Ca by dou t. Okay. This overall equation is called fixed second law of diffusion. What we call fixed second law of diffusion. This overall equation is called fixed second law of diffusion. So now I will just quickly summarize this one, summarize this this equation, what we have to do. Okay. Okay, the starting point for this equation will be fixed first law of diffusion. We already seen what is the fixed first law. Fixed first law is proportionality constant between flux. Flux with respect to some arbitrary coordinate is directly proportional to concentration gradient. The negative sign is there in order to account for lower concentration to higher concentration region. So flux for the proportionality constant replacement, he has used the diffusivity of A to B, diffusivity of A to B, dAb. So this is the fixed first law of diffusion equation. Using this law, we will derive the fixed second law equation. So relationship between fluxes is very much important, which is relationship between Ji into Ni. So we already derived this equation in the previous classes. So Ni is equal to Nxi plus Ji. So this equation, using this equation, we can write that equation for the component A. When we writing component for the component A, we need to replace I with A. So Na is equal to Nxa plus Ja. So we can just, this is molar flux. Na is denoted in molar flux. So we have to write in terms of mass flux. So mass flux, how we can write? So molar flux units are mole per meter square second. So we need to multiply it with molecular weight. Molecular weight has a units of gram per gram mole. So gram mole will be cancelled. The left out terms will be mass flux, gram per meter square second. So we need to multiply this equation to with molecular weight. So that's what we have done in the next equation. So we have already multiplied with Ma into Na, Ma into N into Xi plus Ma into Ja. So as per the definition of concentrations, we know that mole fraction is nothing but individual concentration divided by total concentration. For Xa, for the component A, Xa is equal to Ca by C. That law we will use here. That fact we will use here in the equation 2, so equation 3. So that then we will obtain the equation 4. Then next one is we already know from the definitions of fluxes, Ni is equal to Ci into Ui. Whereas when Ji is there in place of this Ni, we need to substitute Ci of Ui minus U0. Okay, you may remember that equation. So for the common terms, we will write N is equal to C into U. We need not write X. When we are stating what type of vector it is, whether it is a x direction or y direction or in a z direction, we can state it. Otherwise, we can neglect x also. So now we can substitute this fact, Ni is equal to Ci into Ui, in the previous equation, which is equation number 4. When we substitute this, the equation resulting will be this one, Ma into Na is equal to Ma into, in place of capital N, we just substitute C into Ux. And in place of Xi, we just substitute Ca by C. Ca and Ca is cancelled out, and left out terms we have written here. Then next one is the left out terms are Ma into Na is equal to Ma into Ca Ux plus Ma into Ja. So we know that molecular weight multiplied by concentration is nothing but a density, rho A, or a mass concentration. This is a mass concentration. Rho A is equal to Ma into Ca. We have just verified through units also. We have confirmed this fact through their units also. So you can go through this one. Then the left out terms are Ma into Ma. In place of Ca into Ma, we have written rho A. Rho A into U plus Ma into Ja. This is given as equation number 5. So now from this equation, we need to differentiate this equation with respect to x, y, z. Then only we will obtain the next equation 7, 8, 9. Okay, next equation we can obtain. Now this equation needs to be differentiated with respect to x, first step. So with respect to x, we just differentiated this. So the term will be this one. So rho A is also, mass density is also a variable, and vector, this ux is also a variable. So we have to use a variable separable here. Variable separable is stating then one variable, when two variables are there, the one variable when we are differentiating, other variables needs to be put outside of the derivative. So we are putting this outside rho A first time, then differentiating ux. When we are putting outside the ux component, then we are differentiating with respect to x, the density. So left out terms are dou Ma into dou Ja by dou x. Similarly, same thing, we have just simplified here. With respect to what is Ja from the fixed first law of diffusion is minus dAb dou Ca by dou z. We need to just substitute this in equation number 6. Then we will obtain this one. In place of Ja, we are just substituting minus dAb dou Ca by dou z. Then after substituting, we are just multiplying these quantities. Here see, dou A into dou A. Dou into dou is dou square. Dou x into dou x is dou x square. We are just multiplying that one. Simple integration operation there. We are seeing derivative operation, multiplication operation. So this one is common, same as the previous term. And this is also the same as previous term. Only this term will change. Dou square Ca by dou x square. This is given as equation number 7. Now same, we have to differentiate equation number 5 with respect to y. So with respect to y, same thing, we can directly use this equation wherever x is there here. Wherever x is there, we can just write the same variables there and replace this x with y, z respectively. Otherwise, we have to go through all these steps. See, from here to every step, we have to once again derive. Since I have done for you for y component also, you can see here. When we differentiate equation number 5 with respect to y, we will get this one. So Ja, in place of Ja, we will replace this with a fixed first law of diffusion. So fixed first law of diffusion already we substituted here. So dou into dou is dou square, dou x into dou x, this is also a y. This is y, accidentally written x. So I am writing now, here this is y, okay, yeah. Then multiplying that one, dou square Ca by dou y square, we can obtain. Now we already derived two steps, we have taken a long steps. So I am just saying, instead of just deriving all the equation once again, you can just replace this y with z, this all the y's with z. Then simply you can write by your hand instead of deriving all the equation. So same equation, only for z component. All these equations 7, 8, 9, we will substitute in equation number 14 of a continuity equation. Equation number 14 from a continuity equation is this one. I already shown this in from the screenshots of yesterday's live board, this one. So this is that equation number 14. That equation number 14 I have already written here. So in this equation, the equation number 7 will be substituted here. Equation number 8 will be replaced by this variable. Equation number 9 will replace this one. So this is citing this fact, we substitute all equation 7, 8, 9 in equation number 14 of continuity derivation. So when we substitute this much equation we will obtain, including this slide. So we have given this as equation number 10. So we have rho A as a common variable in the three terms. We will separate this rho A, take it common, and here Ma dAb is also common in three variables. We will separate out. So we will just write separately this ux, uy, uz term separately. So So this is the next step. So here we just take a common of density rho a, and all the terms are written in bracket, and ux, uy, uz, we just written in the simply some other terms. Then ma into dat, we already took common and written all the remaining variables in the bracket. So now we have to give a assumption here, apply a assumption here. So the first assumption is no chemical reaction, so that RHS side of this equation, which is the reaction term, which is the generation term, will be cancelled out because of there is no chemical reaction. Then the next assumption is from the continuity equation. Continuity equation, what is it stated from the previous derivation? Dou ux by dou x plus dou uy by dou y plus dou uz by dou z is equal to zero. This whole term is equal to zero is stating by continuity equation. From the continuity equation, we just kept to this zero. And the next assumption is we are assuming the uniform composition. So our density is constant with respect to a spatial coordinate. So every coordinate system, our density is constant. So we will put this all the terms as zero. Then the left out terms are shown in the violet color here. So this is the left out term, and also in the next slide also this is the left out term. We are just writing what are the left out terms here. Minus ma dab, dou square ca by dou x square plus dou square ca by dou y square plus dou square ca by dou z square plus dou rho a by dou t is equal to zero. Now we are sending this LHS term to the RHS, dou rho a by dou t. Then it will become minus, we are just cancelling. We can just divide this equation with ma, or otherwise we can send this ma to this RHS side. So rho a by ma is equal to ca. So this one we are getting. So whole term we are dividing with ma, or otherwise we can send LHS ma from the LHS side to the RHS. Then this term will become rho a by ma is equal to ca. We can just verify the units also. This one ca is equal to rho a by ma. We are substituting this one. The final fixed law, fixed second law of diffusion is nothing but dab whole into dou square ca by dou x square plus dou square ca by dou y square plus dou square ca by dou z square is equal to dou ca by dou t. This is the fixed second law of diffusion. Okay, this has been asked in your old question papers. Many times they have been asked this question. Fixed second law of diffusion and fixed first law of diffusion is obviously they will ask in short answer questions. And continuity equation. Continuity equation, they ask many times, what is the continuity equation? Derive the continuity equation. Since it's a big equation, you have to derive every time. And this is the fixed second law of diffusion. They will ask for the long answers only. This will be asked. So you need to just prepare well these equations. Once we understood this equation, it is very easy to derive. Otherwise, it is very hard to derive. You can't just state what are these variables. Okay, you have to take down the notes. From now onwards, this is the completion of part A. There are three parts in equation unit 1. So this is the completion of part A in unit 1. Next part is the derivations. Four set of derivations will be there. And the final part will be the mass transfer coefficients and then theories related to mass transfer coefficients. Okay, as we go to the next step, the complexity of this mass transfer course will get increased. So when we concentrate in unit 1, then only we can know what are the further units, unit 2, unit 3, unit 4, unit 5. Then only we can know clearly what is going on that operation. These are all, unit 1 is completely basics. There is no unit operation or unit process here. Only these are basics. When you know these equations clearly, what is the fixed first law of diffusion, what is the second law, what is the continuity equation, and what is the definition of mass transfer coefficient, what is the definition of through non-diffusing D or equimolar counter diffusion, then only you can know, you can handle the clear operations like distillation operation and extraction operation and leaching operation. This is for your mass transfer 1. So my sincere request is just please take down the notes, derive on your own this equation, use this video, otherwise use your notes which already uploaded the notes first unit. So just derive this equation. Then you come to know what is the complexity in this derivation, what is the complexity in these partial derivatives, then you come to know. Okay, I hope you understood this thing. Okay, everybody, can you understood?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, everything clear? Voice side? I am not getting any response from voice chat. I don't know why. You are not understanding anything means just you can ask me anytime. These derivations are very important to go further to the next units. Okay, I'm just taking attendance for today. Please bear with me a minute. I think computer is hanging. Okay, I will take attendance. One, number one.
Sensor.
Two is not here. So three. Three. Okay, then four. Yes. Okay, four.
Present, sir.
Five.
Present, sir.
Six.
Present, sir.
Eight. Eight.
Present, sir.
Okay, nine. Number nine. The next one, 11.
Sir. Present, sir.
Okay, 11. 17.
Present, sir.
Okay, 20. 20. Okay. 26.
Sir, 26.
27.
Present, sir.
28. 28. Okay, 28. I am giving option. 30.
Present, sir.
Okay, 32.
Sir.
34.
Present, sir.
39.
Yes, sir.
44.
Present, sir.
47. 49.
47.
Okay, 47, okay. 49. 49. Okay, 49 is absent. 50. Okay. 50. Okay, just you can raise your hand also. Like our 20 raised hand and 50 is also rising hands. So, okay. Yeah. Okay, thank you everybody. I hope you understood this class. This practice. Practice means makes a man perfect. Not a man, woman also. Then please practice it once again. Thank you. Bye.